What's up, everyone? I'm Helena Olamu, and welcome to another episode of the DNA Download, where we explain the science of genetics so you can live in the know. It's an age-old question. Was I born this way? In other words, am I the way that I am because of my DNA or because of my lifestyle and my environment? Is it nature or nurture? Here to help answer this question is Dr. Ruth Tenen, who works on the product science team at 23andMe. Thanks for being here, Ruth.
Thanks for having me.
So, Ruth, how much of who I am comes from my DNA, and how much is due to things I've experienced and been exposed to in my life?
Well, it kind of depends on which aspect of you we're talking about. So some traits, like your blood type, are determined entirely by genetics. Hmm. Others, like whether you like the taste of broccoli, are influenced by both genetics and your experiences.
Oh, so you're saying there's a range in terms of how much genetics influences different traits.
Exactly. So imagine putting your traits along a spectrum, with traits that are strongly influenced by genetics on one side, that's the nature side, and traits that are strongly influenced by environment on the other side, the nurture side. Hmm. That spectrum represents a concept that scientists call heritability.
Heritability. Whew, quick, say that five times fast. So, is it called heritability because you inherit genes from your parents?
Exactly, yep. Okay. So for each trait, heritability is basically just a way of describing how big a role genetics plays in explaining the differences between people. Mm. Now, one really important detail is that heritability applies to populations rather than to individual people. So it can't tell you exactly how big a role genetics plays in determining your individual traits. But it's still a useful jumping off point to help us understand how genetics and environment shape who we are.
Got it. So what are some traits that would fall on the nature side of that spectrum, where genetics plays a big role?
So there are actually some diseases where genetics is pretty much the whole story. So let's use sickle cell anemia as an example. Sickle cell anemia is a disease that affects our red blood cells, and it's caused by a single DNA variant. In order to have sickle cell anemia, a person has to inherit two copies of that variant, one from mom and one from dad.
So you're saying that whether someone has sickle cell anemia is determined entirely by their DNA?
Exactly. But most traits and diseases don't have such a strong genetic component. Instead, they're influenced by lifestyle and environment, too.
Interesting. So I try to eat well and live a healthy lifestyle, although I may indulge in a donut or two.
I am also a huge donut fan. But yeah, lifestyle factors like diet and exercise can make a big difference in our health, even for diseases that are influenced by genetics.
Oh.
So let's take type 2 diabetes. Scientists have identified hundreds of DNA variants associated with type 2 diabetes, but we also know that regardless of our genetics, we can reduce our risk for type 2 diabetes by eating healthy and working out.
So what about traits, like height, for example? I would love to be 2 inches taller. Who do I talk to about that?
Well, unfortunately, I can't help you there, but I can say that height is influenced by both genetics and environment, a combination of kind of nature and nurture.
Wow.
So for example, when I was born, my mom, who's 5 feet tall, my dad, who's 5'6", they were pretty sure I wasn't gonna be the tallest kid in the class.
And that's because genetics plays a big role in determining how tall we are, right?
Exactly, but even though height is influenced strongly by genetics, things like nutrition can also play a role. So, for example, if there's a child who is genetically inclined to be tall, but she doesn't get enough healthy food to eat when she's young, she may end up being shorter than she otherwise would be.
Wow.
And that idea that both genetics and lifestyle and environment are important in shaping who we are and in explaining differences between people is actually true for a whole ton of other traits too, from our personalities to whether we're nearsighted to whether we experience motion sickness.
So when we think about what makes us who we are, whether it's nature or nurture, the answer is usually that it's both.
Exactly. Genetics plays a role, but it usually isn't the whole story.
Wow. That wraps up another episode. Thanks again for being here, Ruth, and we'll see you next time on the DNA Download.